Tristan, I'm so glad that it's summer.
Yeah, man, honestly, I'm ready to get out of here. I'm ready. It's been a long school year.
It has. You know, still, I don't know about taking 5 AP exams next year. I think it might be a bit much.
You should just be like me and not take APs because you're dumb.
I think you should take 8 more APs with me, Tristan.
Nah, that's ridiculous. You should come to our wrestling camp over the summer.
Tristan, I already joined the track camp, though.
Did you actually?
But I might.
Oh. Well, you got my hopes up there for a second. You really did.
Well, I mean, I don't think I'm, like, I don't think I have the physique for wrestling.
I think you'd be surprised, yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe.
You know, yeah. I have, like, 5 things of summer work that I need to do. I'll probably do them, like, July.
July, yeah. I have, like, nothing to do over the summer, so my plan is just to work my 2 jobs.
I'm telling you, that's insane, and you need to get something besides 2 jobs. Maybe just 1.
Well, I'm going to go to the gym in between, so that's, like, that's something else besides my 2 jobs. Like, when I get the break in between my jobs.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, because, I mean, like, how else am I going to hit 495 on bench press?
Yeah.
You'll never hit that.
Thank you,
Balt. Who asked you, bro? Who asked?
Oh, Tristan, you know what time it is. It's 11:55, and I mean, they want us out of the school. We've already taken our last exams for this year. Let's get on out of here. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. They got the homework and the test to face each day. No matter how tough it may seem, they got the spirit and the will to learn to make sure their dreams will be achieved. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. They're the students of the school. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. Learning is their golden rule. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. They'll study hard to reach the stars. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. The power of knowledge is on their side. Together they will strive for success. United in friendship, divided by cliques. Never giving up, they'll pass each test. Yeah, Greenville Senior High. They're the students of the school. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. Learning is their golden rule. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. They'll study hard to reach the stars. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. Here come the students at Greenville Senior High. Learning and growing each day. Greenville Senior High. Making memories along the way. Greenville Senior High. They'll shine bright as they pave their path. Yeah, here come the students of Greenville Senior High. Here come the students at Greenville Senior High. Learning and growing each day. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. Making memories along the way. Here come the students of Greenville Senior High. They'll shine bright as they pave their paths. Greenville Senior High.
Yeah? Oh.
Where's that notebook? Summer work, formula sheet, notes, practice problems, calculator policy. I have less than 5 hours to finish all of this. Where's my schedule? AP Chem's my first period. Well, I'm dead.
Fellow AP Chem students, today I stand before you, fully aware of the daunting journey that lies ahead. The path we have chosen to tread as seekers of scientific knowledge and understanding. As you embark on this adventure, let us acknowledge the challenges that await you. For it is through these trials that you shall grow and excel. As confident and hopeful AP Chemistry students, you stand on the cusp of greatness. Let us reflect on the changes that have shaped your summer work, allowing you to navigate this challenging yet exhilarating course. In the past, we often found ourselves drowning in an ocean of vocabulary, endless terms and definitions that seemed useless, disconnected from the bigger picture. The memorization of these isolated words will not be required in this new era of summer work. Recapping the units is a necessity to solidify our foundation before diving into the complexities of AP chemistry. I am thrilled to announce that this vital piece practice remains intact. You shall continue to revisit these units, reinforcing our knowledge and embracing the interconnections that make this subject so fascinating. And let us not forget the indispensable practice problems. In the past, they were the guiding light, helping to apply our theoretical knowledge to real-world scenarios. The importance of practice problems have not waned. You will persist in solving these intricate puzzles, honing your analytical skills, and preparing yourselves for the challenges that lie ahead. But now, new horizons have emerged on the AP chemistry landscape. We find ourselves entrusted with the care of our calculators, for they have become an integral part of our scientific toolkit. A calculator care policy now exists, reminding us to handle these precious devices with utmost caution and respect. Let us embrace this responsibility, ensuring the longevity and reliability of these invaluable tools. Furthermore, a significant addition to our arsenal is the inclusion of a comprehensive formula sheet. This sheet, my friends, shall be our ally, a concise compilation of the fundamental equations and constants we need to tackle the intricate problems that await us. Remember, this resource is to be cherished, printed, kept close at hand, a testament to our commitment to mastery. Your academic year will be measured in grades, a collection of assessments designed to evaluate your progress and mastery of the subject. You will face an array of minor grades, major reviews, and unit tests, each carrying its own weight, determining our understanding of the concepts you will explore. In the realm of mastering chemistry applications, you shall find a series of minor grades, 6 of them to be exact, in the first quarter, another 6 in the second quarter, an additional 6 in the third quarter. These minor grades, though seemingly small, are the stepping stones that pave the way for our understanding and command of the subject. A major review awaits, a singular assessment that bears the weight of your cumulative knowledge, an opportunity to showcase your powers in the realm of mastering chemistry applications. Moving beyond the realm of mastering chemistry, you encounter the towering presence of major grades, 3 of them in each quarter, serving as pillars of assessments, testing our understanding and ability to apply our knowledge. These major grades shall be scrutinized and graded through external sources, with the lowest available grade standing at a respectable 70. These major grades serve as a testament to your dedication and commitment, reflecting the depth of your knowledge. Throughout the year, you shall also encounter quizzes, both minor and mid-unit, and in long units like thermodynamics and acids and bases. You shall face 2 additional quizzes, urging you to dive deeper into the complexities of these subjects. Amidst the assessments, there are moments of review and reflection, 9 review sheets, some contributing to our major grades, others counting towards our minor grades, serving as stepping stones to consolidate our knowledge. They guide us in our journey towards mastery, ensuring that we build a strong foundation for the challenges that lie ahead. As you progress through the academic year, you will face a midterm or semi-final, a major grade that compels us to demonstrate our cumulative knowledge, bringing together the concepts that have learned thus far. And let us not forget that unexpected opportunities may arise, offering extra credit grades and the chance to showcase our true potential. The end review brings forth 3 minor grades in the form of quizzes, completed by a major grade multiple choice test, a major grade lab-based assessment, and a major grade free response question. Additionally, we have 3 4-day participation minor grades, emphasizing the value of active engagement and collaborative learning. But the journey does not end with the AP exam. Post-exam, a new task awaits, a final project that encourages you to reflect upon your experience. You'll be given the opportunity to shape the future of AP chemistry, presenting your ideas and suggestions to make this course even better. This project holds 2 major grades and 2 minor grades, rewarding you for your creativity and innovative thinking. Dear peers, as confident AP chemistry students, you stand at the Dear peers, as confident AP chemistry students, You stand at the precipice of greatness. You will face an array of assessments, challenges, and opportunities. Embrace each hurdle with determination and enthusiasm. Support one another, for in this collective effort, some shall emerge as scientists, thinkers, and champions of knowledge. I have witnessed the evolution of our summer work, a transformation that reflects the evolving nature of this course. The path ahead is challenging, but you are prepared. March forward, armed with knowledge and curiosity, embracing the journey that lies before you. With your classmates, you shall conquer the complexities of AP Chemistry, unraveling its secrets, determination in your hearts, and chemistry in your souls. You shall become the architects of your own success.
All right, so for Unit 1, you're going to learn about electron-electron repulsion. An example of that is oxygen in this group. There are exceptions in Unit 1. That's D4 and D9. It's most stable when half or completely full. You're going to learn about oxidation numbers, which actually you should already know, quantum numbers, and that's specific to level, sublevel, orbital, and whether the arrow goes up and down, up or down. You're going to learn about PES models, which is like the relative intensity, which is like the number of electrons, and then like its nuclear charge or whatever, its pole. Nuclear charge, you're going to learn about that. It's effective pull coming from the nucleus. You should already know electronegativity. Ionization energy, you should already know. You're going to learn about Beer's law, which is absorbance is directly related to concentration. And Coulomb's laws, which is attraction depends on size of charge and distance between them. You should already know, like, most of that. This is Unit 2, IMFs and other stuff. You're going to learn about double bonds and triple bonds and single bonds or whatever, and it's like the shorter it gets, the stronger it gets, so double is shorter, so it's stronger than single. You're going to learn about resonance structures. You're going to also learn about formal charge, which is really easy. You should already remember all your IMS and like their strengths and which one is stronger and stuff like that, vapor pressure and boiling point and freezing point and stuff like that. And you're going to learn about sigma and pi bonds. Well, a single bond has one sigma bond, or I say bond, or whatever. Single is like one sigma, double is one sigma and one pi, and triple is one sigma and two pi. You're going to learn about bond orders, stuff like that. And there's not really that much more stuff to that. It's just that. It should be really easy. All right, this is Unit 3. You're going to learn about Dalton's law of partial pressure, which is some of all individual pressures that make the gases make up. You should already know pressure, the definition of that. You're going to learn about kinetic molecular theory. All matter made up particles are in constant motion. Temperature, you should already know that. PVN or TU, you should already know that. All the other stuff. You should also know the maximum Boltzmann graph and some other calculations for partial pressures that he's going to go over, and how to get each individual pressure. Gases are ideal at high temps and low pressures. And you should already know Brinkelhoff. And there's a graph that has a triple point, but I forgot the name of it. And so yeah, just a bunch of math. That should be easy. All right, for Unit 4, which is thermo, you should already know endo and exo. You're gonna learn about Hess's law. And the delta S, which is really important, and that's like randomness. It was on your little vocab thing, which is the measure of randomness. So if it's positive, it's more random, and if it's negative, it's less random or more ordered. And it's favorable if it's more random, so positive. You're gonna learn about delta G and a bunch of other formulas for delta G and for that unit. Everything else is really just fast review. Oh yeah, you're gonna learn about delta H effusion, delta H vaporization, sublimation, like 3 or 5 steps for that, and you're gonna learn about energy diagrams and heat curves. This is for kinetics. This is completely new, so like it's pretty easy. He's gonna do like coin things. It'll tell us how quickly a reaction occurs, must be done experimentally, collision theory, for two things to react, they must collide in proper orientation with enough energy to overcome the EA. He's going to talk about the factors that affect the rate, the rate law, it's just the rate law, it's like an equation, then there's orders, 0, 1st, and 2nd, which are basically just exponents. The rate constant is K. Rate is inversely related to EA. Then he's going to talk about the plots. The slowest step of the mechanism determines the rate, so look at the slowest. The only way to change K is to book a temp, or to change temp intermediate is a product than the reactant. Energy things, rate, and yeah, that's it. This is for Unit 6, solutions. Ionic substances dissolve and disassociate, so they break into their ions. Then you're going to talk about solubility rules. I have a little acronym for this thing, but I'm not going to tell you. Solubility, you're sure you know that. Oh, yeah, you're going to talk about I. So, like, for an ionic, like, thing, if it's, like, NaCl, then I is 2, is basically just a subscript, but for, like, H2O, it's 0, and, like, for, like, glucose, it's 1, because it's not ionic. And then, colligative properties, the more stuff in a solution, the more it's going to change from its regular BP and FP, which is a freezing point. You don't know about equations, K, and the rest is just math, so, yeah, just... Good luck. Alright, 3 more units. Equilibrium. This one's okay. It's not that hard. K is just products over reactants, and that's for like pretty much everything. K expression only includes aqueous and gases, no liquids or solids. I'm not reading that. Q is the reaction quotient, so like it tells you the direction compared to like K and stuff. I feel like that makes sense. Oh yeah, Rice tables. That's pretty like self-explanatory when he explains it. The stats, stressors change the directions. He's gonna talk about all that good stuff. Yeah, I'm not reading that because he's gonna tell it, so there's no point. Yeah, I mean, that's just pretty easy. It's just math. I'm not... Yeah, that's it. Alright, acids and bases is the hardest thing, so I'm not gonna talk that much about it. You sure you know all the calcs, but that's for mainly, like... Strong bases and acids. Salt could be acidic or basic. T's gonna tell you about the 7 strong acids and the 7-8 strong bases. He's gonna talk about conjugate acids and bases, which is like a buffer. Then he's gonna talk about formulas, pH equivalence point, moles of acid and base are equal. He's gonna talk about calcs. Try to listen to that because that's like really important. Then he's going to talk about like a little diagram that shows like different steps, like half equivalence point, and like the starting point, like pH for like a strong base or like a strong acid, weak acid, whatever. And then, yeah, buffers, I already said that. And then, yeah, just some, yeah, it's just that. All right, this is the final unit. So like for Chem, it was the easiest because like 10 people got 100. So like, he's gonna tell you about the net ionic equation. That's pretty easy, just remember the steps. He's gonna talk about voltaic and electrolytic. Remember that voltmeter for voltaic and power supply for electrolytic. And he's gonna talk about delta G with those as well. He's gonna talk about calcs as well, reduction potentials. And then he's gonna talk about plating steps, which are pretty easy to remember if you like try to remember each day. He's gonna talk about the positive electrode, negative electrode is anode. Oh, electrons flow alphabetically, so it goes from anode to cathode. Look at ratios when trying to get the number of electrons. Yeah, red cat and the nox, they're like stuff he uses, which are really helpful, but you only have to remember really one of them. Then he's gonna give you like a big diagram or something that you need to fill out with like plating and anodes and cathodes and anions and anions, and I'm pretty sure that's it.
Oh man, Rio was great. I am so happy to be back home now. I'm so sad spring break is ending so soon. It's been such an amazing year. Dallas Cowboys win the Super Bowl 2024. Final quarter comeback. Get 10 points in one quarter to win it all. Dak Prescott will stay for another year, finally getting us a Super Bowl. Yeah, region, Rio, it's been a great year. And now, I'm going back to school tomorrow, which is... I don't want to go back to school. I wonder what we're doing when we go back to school. Oh yeah, it's time for the final review. Since how many weeks? It's only like 5 weeks left before AP exam, and then like 4 more weeks after that. So I think, what did our teacher say about that? I feel like I remember hearing something about the final exam. What was it? Oh yeah. We're going to spend 2 weeks, we're going to spend all of the 5 weeks on review. Those first 2 weeks we're going to be on review videos, and we're going to have 3 review quizzes within that first 2 weeks on all of the 9 units. And then for that first week after that, it was going to be multiple choice review. And then it was going to be lab-based review, and then FRQ-based review. And for each of those review weeks, there is going to be one major assessment or major quiz and a participation grade for the entirety of the week. Yes. Well, spring break's over. You know, I cannot wait until my Super Bowl shirt comes in, because I don't know where it's been. I put in the offer, and my Super Bowl shirt was supposed to get here, but it just didn't. So still waiting on that. Spring break, I was gonna wear it all over Rio, show my repping of the Dallas Cowboys, but I could only wear this one. So, that's kind of... So, time to review. Hopefully I get a 5 on this exam. I think I get Chem 1010 and Chem 1020 for Clemson credit if I get a 5 on this. I think I'm going to get a 5 on this, you know? The year is almost over, and all I had to do was just review. I think I'm going to get a 5 on this. I think I'm going to get a 5 on this. Whew. Well. Just finished the AP test. And that was... I don't know. A 5, 4, 3. Definitely 3. Let's not go down to 2 and 1. We don't do that here. It's been a long year, hasn't it? Feels like just yesterday I had forgot to do my AP Chem summer work. And now we're here. AP test is over. It's like nothing else really to do. Gonna go to class and play board games all day. Maybe Sporkle. Well, except there's one last thing to worry about. All the other grades are in except for the final project. Two majors, two minors. How would I make AP Chem better? That was a hard one. I mean, summer work. I hear that was been streamlined since last year. Review was easy. The grading scale seemed fair, and I mean, I love my 99 for quarter one, my 98 for quarter two, my 97 for quarter three, my soon-to-be 100 for quarter four. Oh yeah, no, all those look nice, so can't really say anything about that. The in-class operations, I like that AP Classroom wasn't mandatory. I'm really glad that I didn't have to do like a large mastering chem, only one of those. The weekly ones, they were pretty good. I like that. The tests, I always ranked mid there. There are always people smarter than me out there, always taking number one spot. Still mad I didn't get number one spot one day. Not surpass 90s in test. Never reaching that coveted 100. Wow, that. Thinking about that, that hurt. That hurts a bit. Maybe might change that a bit so I can at least get 100 on a test. The final review. 5 weeks. 2 weeks of review. Three quizzes during the review of the units. Multiple choice week. Lab week. FRQ week. AP test. Oh, prom was there too. Love that. That was wild. I was not expecting prom to be that wild. Wow. You know, I crowd surfed. Okay, sorry. Getting off topic. But I mean, I don't really know how to make AP Chem better now. I mean, I thought a year ago that some of the things that the last class had entered put in there, like I didn't think that all that stuff that they were talking about was gonna work. I mean, I remember that video from the start of the year, and they were like, "Nah, no way they did it well, that well." But like, they've done pretty good. I mean, I've worked through it. I mean, looks good, and I'm here, and I believe I got a 3 at least. So, and they did pretty good. So, what am I gonna do? What is my project gonna be? How am I gonna make AP Chem better? What is AP Chem missing? That's it. AP Chem's missing you. Yeah. You right now. Look, you gotta roll with me here. AP Chem is great. It's been streamlined. The summer work for it is challenging, and it works. The few first weeks, you review, you get inside the game, inside the mindset for AP Chem. And then, once you get the ball rolling with the first unit, it just keeps on rolling, and everything is just so natural and just goes by. Your grades look amazing compared to your other AP classes. Yes. I'm sure about this. That's all AP Chem's missing. Is you. Because that's the thing that made AP Chem the best. Gotta admit, great teacher. Even better classmates. AP Chem is missing you. Now look. I know I'll go on record. I've said it's challenging. I've said it's hard. I said it's annoying. I said I don't want to study for it. But 1 year later, It's worth it. And it needs you. It needs the next generation. And you're it. A journey is awaiting you. It's going to be long. Going to have some twists and turns. And in the end, you're going to come out with a 5 because you're probably much better than I am at chemistry. Got to admit, I had like an 89 in chemistry honors, so I probably shouldn't have come here, but at the end of it, looking pretty good out here. So, that's it. Guess that's... it's been a year. So, I want you, come take this journey that I've taken. AB Chemistry, it's for you. Trust me.